Okay, so for this problem, what they're wanting you to do is to identify what part of the basic accounting equation is affected, and is it increased or decreased? And so for this example, you really have to understand the basic accounting equation: assets equal liabilities plus stockholders' equity. And so assets, again, are things that the company owns, things like cash and accounts receivable and notes receivable and buildings and land and equipment and office supplies, things like that would be included here in the assets. Liabilities are things that the company owes, and those would be things like accounts payable, notes payable, taxes payable, unearned revenue. Those types of things are going to be liabilities. And then the last part is stockholders' equity, and this is going to include your common stock, your revenue, your expenses, and your dividends. Remember, your revenue, your expenses, and your dividends are all get rolled up into retained earnings. So common stock and retained earnings make up that stockholders' equity section, and that's what the SE stands for. And so if we look at a couple of transactions, what this problem is asking you to do is tell whether each of these items in the basic accounting equation has increased or decreased. And you know, simply by looking at the basic accounting equation, that this has to hold true. Assets have to equal liabilities plus stockholders' equity. So most of the time, if something is affected on this side of the accounting equation, something is going to be affected on this side of the accounting equation. So let's just go through a couple of examples. The very first example is someone has invested cash into a business. In this case, it's a service-based company, and they receive common stock. So again, whenever you're reading these transactions, you're always going to think about it from the accountant or the bookkeeper for the company's point of view, not from your individual point of view. So you got to kind of flip your mentality. You're not thinking of it from an individual's household. You're thinking of it from the accountant or the bookkeeper for the company's point of view. And how would these transactions affect the company's records? So if someone invested cash into a business or any other asset for that matter, it could be land, it could be building, it could be a piece of equipment, in exchange for common stock, which proves that they have ownership in the company, then your assets would go up, right? Cash specifically, and your stockholders' equity would go up because you would be issuing them common stock. Okay, and common stock falls under stockholders' equity. And so you would check the box that says asset increase and stockholders' equity increase. If we borrowed money from the bank or we bought something on account, then your liabilities would increase, right? If we borrow money from a bank, that would be notes payable. If we bought something from on account, that would be accounts payable. And if we borrowed money from a bank, that our cash would increase, so our assets would increase. Okay, so you kind of see the flow here. Anytime something happens on one side of the accounting equation, it has to happen on the other side of the accounting equation. If you bought something on account, maybe we bought office supplies or we bought some equipment on account, again, your assets would go up and your liabilities, specifically accounts payable, would go up. And so you're affecting both sides of the accounting equation, and both sides of the accounting equation have to either go up or down in the same fashion. So let's look at another example. Let's say we provided some service to a customer and they paid us cash. Okay. Once you provide service to a customer or you sell goods to a customer, that's always revenue or income, whichever one you want to call it. And so revenue or income falls under the stockholder's equity section because that's part of retained earnings. And so if we provide service to a customer and they pay us right away, our cash is going to be increasing, right? That's an asset. And our stockholder's equity is going to be increasing because that's going to increase our revenue, which in turn increases retained earnings and increases your stockholder's equity section. If we provided service to a customer on account, in other words, we provided the service and they're going to pay us sometime in the future. Anytime it says we're providing service on account or we left a bill, something like that, then that's going to be accounts receivable. Okay, that's an asset. Accounts receivable is an asset. It shows that we have the right to receive that money sometime in the future. The company has the right to receive that money sometime in the future. So again, we've provided the service. It doesn't matter whether the customer paid us right then or not. As soon as you provide that service, you recognize revenue. So that's going to increase your stockholders' equity, right? Because that's revenue. And it's going to increase your accounts receivable, which is an asset. Anytime you pay for something that is a cost of the current accounting period, like salaries or rent or advertising or utilities expense or miscellaneous expense, you've paid for something, so your cash is going to go down, right? And that's an asset. And your stockholders' equity is going to go down because that's going to be an expense, a cost of a current accounting period, like rent or utilities or miscellaneous expense or office supplies that you're using up. All of those are going to increase your expenses, which reduces your retained earnings. So stockholders' equity is going to be decreased every time expenses go up. So again, you can see the one-for-one relationship. On the left-hand side of the accounting equation, assets are going down. And on the right-hand side of the accounting equation, stockholders' equity is going down. Now, you could have a situation where everything happens on the left-hand side of the accounting equation. Maybe you have two assets that are being affected. For instance, a customer paid on their account, right? We provided them services sometime a little bit ago, and now they're paying on their account. They have an accounts receivable with us. They owe us, let's say, $1,000, and they're paying that $1,000 to us right now. And so our cash would go up. That's an asset. And another asset, accounts receivable, would go down. And so in that case, you would mark the box or you would check the box that says assets increase and assets decrease, because you have one asset that's increasing and one asset that's decreasing. Okay, so it doesn't have to be both sides of the accounting equation, as long as these two here on this side will cancel each other out, because my cash is going to go up by $1,000 and my accounts receivable is going to go down by $1,000. Dividends paid to an owner, okay, that is giving the owner back some of their money. And so again, your cash is going to go down, you're going to be writing them a check. And dividends make stockholders' equity or retained earnings go down, so your stockholders' equity is going to go down. So you would mark the box, assets did decrease and stockholders' equity decreases. Okay, so hopefully that gives you a little bit more insight into this type of problem.